One granny is approximately 13 centimeters diameter and 10 centimeters on each side. It depends on how tight or how loose you crochet. So I'm a regular crocheter, so this is my size. Fit it around your body. This point should be approximately over your breasts. If not, you have to make one more. So, we'll start with this one. And then we will continue on with week two. So, first the grannies, then the rest. Let's start. For the beginners who knows, for all who know who to how to make a magic circle, please do so. If you don't, chain up four and slip stitch into the first single crochet. First chain. I make a magic circle, so I chain 1, 2, 3. That is directly my first double crochet, plus two more in the magic circle, so, or magic ring, how you want to call it. We will start off with making a regular base for the granny square, only we chain 1 instead of 2 or 3. Then you make 3 more double crochets in the magic circle, chain 1, 3 more, 1, 2, and number 3. Now you've got 3 sets of 3 double crochets. I have to tie it up a bit because otherwise I will lose my tail. Chain 1 and then the last 3 double crochets in the magic circle, 1, 2 and number 3, chain 1 and pull tight to close the ring, and then you will slip stitch into the third 1, 2, 3 chain from the first chain 3 you made. Oh, that's a bit too tight. So this is how it should look like. It's like a little ring, but we will make it a square. So slip stitch until you are in the chain 1 space between the 3 double crochets. Here it is. Chain up 3. Chain 2 more double crochets and make 2 more double crochets in the chain 1 space. Now chain 1. Make 3 double crochets in the same chain 1 space. 2, 3. Now the tricky part. Before we go to the next chain 1 space, we will make chain 1. Yes? Now, you've made your chain 1 and then you will continue. 3 double crochets, chain 1, 3 double crochets in the same chain 1 space from the previous row. So, 1, 2, and number 3. Now you made your second corner. Chain 1. Go to the next chain 1 space. Make 3 double crochets. 1, 2, 3. Chain 1. And 3 more double crochets in the same chain 1 space. Now you made your third corner. Chain 1. And into the last chain 1 space, you will make 3 double crochets, 1, 2, and number 3, chain 1, and 3 more double crochets, 2, 3, chain 1, and then slip stitch into the third chain from the beginning chain 3. So, now I've got 4 corners. Chain 3 stands for your first double crochet. Now, short explanation. While you're crocheting on the right side of your work, your working chain or stitch is on the right side of your double crochet, not on the left. So, keep that in mind throughout all of the rows, otherwise you will lose one double crochet, or you don't have one double crochet, and then you have a problem in the second week of this carding. So, here's my double crochet, and here is my chain, a stitch where I have to make my double crochet into. That's number two. Here is my third. Make a third double crochet. Now we're in chain one space. Instead of three double crochets, we make two double crochets, chain one, two double crochets. So that's the first one, that's the second one. Chain one and add two more double crochets in that chain one space. That's number two. Now, don't forget that your working chain is on the right side of your work, so you have to pull it up a bit, move it sideways, and here is the chain or the stitch where you have to work in with. So there you put your first double crochet, one, then number two, and number three. Now you have your chain one, you will skip that one and you go directly into the next working stitch. So that's we're on the right side of the double crochet. There you make three double crochets, so that's one double crochet on every double crochet you will see in this row. That's three. In the chain one space you will make two double crochets, one and number two, chain one and two more double crochets in that same chain one space. Move it up a bit. Here is the chain, the stitch. So chain one, a double crochet one. In the second you will make one double crochet and in the third one double crochet. Here is your chain one. You will skip that one and go directly into that next stitch. One double crochet on top of each of the double crochets you will see. That's three. So now the chain one space again, two double crochets, one, two, chain one, add two more double crochets. Move it up. Here is the stitch. One double crochet in the next three stitches. Two and number three. Skip the chain one and go directly into the next stitch. Make three double crochets. One, two, and number three. Chain one space. Make two double crochets. Chain one, two more double crochets. Now, skip, move it up. Here's the next stitch. One double crochet in the next three double crochets from the previous row. And now, here is your chain one. You will skip that one and go into the third chain from the base and slip stitch. Now you have 10 double crochets here, 10 double crochets here, here and there, and we will start up with the last and final row of this granny square. Chain up three, one, two, three, double crochet into the next and into the next. So on top of all double crochets you make one double crochet. Within a chain one space you make two double crochets, one and number two, chain one, two double crochets in the same chain one space. Move it up, make 10 double crochets, so one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and that's number 10. Make two double crochets in the chain one space, chain up one, and then repeat it. So two double crochets, you have to move it up a bit, here's your stitch. Now you make 10 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. In the next chain one space, you will make 2 double crochets, chain 1, 2 more double crochets, move it up, here is the working stitch, make 10 double crochets, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Chain 1 space, you will make 2 double crochets, 1, 2, chain 1, 2 more double crochets, move it up, and you finish off with 5 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, and that's 5. Slip stitch into the third chain from the chain 3 you made in the beginning, and you have your first granny finished. Now I'll show you a little tips and tricks to finish off. I call it the Hupsa way. So, 1, 2 chains, cut your yarn. Yes, that's short. Haha, I will show you. Pull the yarn through, tie it up, grab your nails, and move the two knots, the two single crochets, chains to your work, and it's stuck. You see? This made a little tiny bit of knot, but you don't feel it when you're working with it. The next row you will single crochet around it and it's gone. You don't see it anymore. So, this is the granny. You make approximately 5 for a small medium. I think it's in the US around size 6, I think. I have a little overview on the website, on the Facebook page, so you can check it up there. You make 5 for this for a small medium, 6 up to 7 for a large, etc, etc. And then if you have time over for the next of the week, you will make at least 2 grannies for the arm, so that's 4 for one body, and at least 7 grannies for the bottom of this cardigan. We'll start up next week with attaching these grannies to each other, and we will make the body of the cardigan. Well, I will say good luck, thumbs up, please subscribe to my channel, and like my videos. So, see you next week. Bye bye.